the woman now labelled as Europe's first female suicide bomber, Hasna Aydbulahsen. It's now been confirmed that she was at the flat, raided by French armed police on Wednesday morning. Her passport was found at the scene. Also there was Abdelhamid Abaoud, identified as the most likely organiser of last Friday's barbaric shooting and bombing spree in Paris. Here you can hear what are thought to be her last words. Where is your boyfriend? A policeman shouts. He's not my boyfriend, she replies. Soon after there was an explosion, French police said a woman wearing a suicide vest was killed. Hasna Aydbulahsen's mother lives in another Paris suburb where armed police came last night. We met a school friend of Hasna's who said she couldn't believe she became a terrorist.
She loved life. I don't think she had the intention to be a suicide bomber. I don't think she planned it. It was a last-minute thing. She was influenced. She was vulnerable. She was fragile.
Neighbour Zahir Degain says he knew the family well. Hasna used to come here to his house to visit his daughters.
A year ago, a year and a half, she was dressed in the European way, with a handbag, and suddenly she started wearing the hijab. But despite that, she still said hello. We really never suspected she would become like that.
No one was at the family home today.
From speaking to several people, we've built up a picture of a young woman who enjoyed life in this deprived suburb of Paris. Yes, apparently she had a difficult upbringing and the family had problems. But the people we've spoken to knew a young woman who had nothing to do with the extremist, violent ideology of so-called Islamic State.
So, was she radicalised? Were drugs or money involved? How did a 26-year-old French woman become embroiled in modern France's worst-ever terror attack? Tom Burridge, BBC News, in Paris.